Howdy, another week's gone by, can't believe that. If you've watched these videos before, you probably know by now, I'm Dave Wood, and of course, this is Semiosis 101. So if you want to, you can fast forward to today's video, but if you are a newbie, stay exactly where you are. This will be your first Semiosis 101 video. I'm Dave Wood, a design educator and researcher, a published design author, and I've worked commercially as both a freelance illustrator and graphic designer. I actually use semiotics all the time in my creative work, but probably like yourselves, I was never taught semiotic theory at design school. I'm a scouser from Liverpool and a new Scot, and this scouse-scot Semiosis 101 YouTube channel focuses on explaining Peircean semiotic theory in a more design-centric way to visual communication designers, illustrators, graphic designers. The guy behind the theory, Charles Sanders Peirce, wrote the theory in late 19th, early 20th century in North America, and he was a philosopher, a mathematician, and a theorist, but he wasn't a creative. I have a PhD in visual communication, and it took until my doctorate to actually study semiotic theory in order to really understand how to apply semiosis, the act of sign action of semiotic signs, when producing visual communication work. Each week on the scouse-scot Semiosis 101 YouTube channel, I'll post at least one 10-minute explainer video on an aspect of Peirce's pragmatic semiotic theory. Each free Semiosis 101 10-minute video will use design-centric terms instead of Peirce's theoretical language so that illustrators and graphic designers can follow and understand. Each video will feature a take-home piece of applicable semiotic theory, and they do interconnect to build up your understanding of semiosis. But this channel is not a course in semiotics per se. Instead, think of each video as a bite-sized piece of new knowledge on semiosis. The aim of these three videos is to take Peirce's quite complex philosophical, theoretical language and put it in a new context of designing visual communication, whether these are illustrations, motion, branding, packaging, editorial, etc. So whether you are just interested in semiotics, or you are a semiotician, a visual communicator, an illustrator, or a graphic designer, interested in knowing how Peirce's semiosis theory can help to enhance your visual communication skills, then please like these videos. Subscribe to this channel below. And if you want to be notified when next week's video is published on YouTube, hit the bell button. Okay, let's get to the fourth episode on general Peircean semiotic theory for illustrators and designers. Today, in around 10 minutes, we will focus on explaining the sign action of semiosis using a box metaphor. Peirce created the name semiosis and defined its meaning as sign action. Semiosis is explained by using a box metaphor coined by Roderick Munday. Through this metaphor, we will explore how the client, the creative, and the audience are all crucial to effective semiotic visual communication. This new semiotic understanding will help you see your visual communication abilities in a new way. It will be a theory-packed 10 minutes of semiosis, but as usual, in design-centric terms. So stay tuned, subscribe, hit that bell button, let's go. Okay, so in this video, we'll unpack semiosis, sign action, and how sign action works. Just to give an understanding of that first before we move on to anything else. Okay, so within Daniel Chandler's excellent book, Semiotics, The Basics, he talks within there about Peircean theory, and he uses a metaphor that I think, if I'm correctly remembering it, one of his students, Roderick Munday, developed to explain what semiosis is and how semiosis works. And he uses the metaphor of a box. So that's what we'll focus in on for the majority of this 10-minute talk. So here we are, we have a box, and this is going to be our metaphor for how Peirce's semiotic theory, sign action, works. So the sign itself represents something to us. So we see the box, it represents something to us. What it represents to us, by looking at the box, the sign, we get to see something that we think it means. So we interpret the something from the semiotic sign's representation. So how we see the box, how the box is represented to us, we can't help but put in our mind something that we think that this is representing. Our interpretation of that something connects directly to the intended message, if it's successful. So here we have sign action working. The sign that we want to communicate, the concept we want to be communicated, represents something to us as the audience. How it's represented, we interpret how it's represented. That puts in our mind a picture of what we think this is about, an idea, a concept of what is this is about. Now that concept that we interpret from what we see, if effective, if semiotics is being used effectively and you understand who your audience are and what they will know and what they won't know, then it should connect back to the message that we need to communicate. Triadic, a three-step approach. Concept, representation, interpretation. Concept, its representation, which is the box. This is what we see as the box before we open it. Once we open it, we see inside it, that is what I thought it was going to be. It's not a surprise, we get to see. So it doesn't really matter how ornate the box is in its representation, as long as it communicates what we need it to communicate, that's what happens. So the concept being the box to its representation, through its representation, not to, through its representation to its effective interpretation should lead us back to the concept. So the intended message is concept. The semiotic representation of that leads us to the audience's interpretation of that, which then leads us back to the concept, the intended message's concept. The intended message's concept leads us to the semiotic representation, leads us to effectively, if it's done effectively, the audience's interpretation, which leads us hopefully back to the intended message we needed to get across. In Professor Tony Jaffe's excellent book, Introduction to Peircean Visual Semiotics, which was a godsend to me when I was trying to understand this as part of my PhD. This book here talks in more accessible terms about Peirce's determination flow. And that's what we're talking about here, this triadic nature of a determination flow from the concept through how it's represented to its interpretation back to the concept. This interpretation is important to get back to the concept. So Tony Jaffe talks about the determination flow in more accessible terms than Peirce does. And this is my designer-centric simplification of what all that means as sign action, as semiosis, as sign action. The concept to be visually communicated, how the concept is represented, and how the representation is interpreted, which leads us back to the message we got, the concept to be visually communicated. So this is a cycle that comes from the intention through the visual communication designer, the graphic designer, illustrator at stage two, onto the audience at stage three, and the audience then, through the effective visual communication, understands what they're looking at. It means this. This means this. That means that. Sean Hall's excellent book as well. So the sign action, just to summarise it all, the sign action within Peircean semiotic theory is comprised of this triad underpinning it. So it goes beyond the signifier and the signified,
because it pulls in the important aspect to all of this, which is the audience. And that's one of the really key things that is really crucial when it comes to understanding how effective Peircean semiotic theory can be once understood and applied into your ideation phases in your illustration, graphic design work that you do. This is what encapsulates it. So it's this triad that forms the fundamentals of semiosis. The concept, how it's represented, how it's interpreted. And just to put back in the problematic words from Peirce, object, representment, and interpretant. So this sort of shows you the remit behind all of these videos on this channel, all the future videos that's going to be coming up, is to translate the problematic terminology that Peirce has in his philosophical theory on semiotics into designer-centric terms that illustrators and graphic designers and other designers can understand, appreciate, and see the relevance into their own design process where they come from. So it's not about dumbing down semiotic theory, it's about opening it up in its language into real-world contexts for designers and illustrators.
So that is our 10 minutes of Peircean Semiosis 101 for this week. Thanks to Munday's box metaphor, we now have a clear understanding of how Peirce's sign action works in practice. Peirce's semiosis involves three things working together: the intended concept to be communicated, how we shape that concept visual representation within illustration or graphic design, and how our target audience interprets the concept connotatively from our design visual communications. By putting Peirce's complex theoretical language into designer-centric terms, we see how semiosis forms an underpinning structure to enhance how we visually communicate with more precision through manipulating that sign action. We can move beyond Peirce's obtuse choice of words and move deeper into the benefits of understanding semiosis for visual communicators. So over the coming weeks in Semiosis 101, we will explore how this pragmatic relationship of a determination flow of the three aspects of sign action will positively impact on illustration and graphic design. I hope as creatives you agree that Peirce's semiotic theory of semiosis offers a lot of rich pickings to enhance our visual communication skills. There will be another video next week, so come back again. By following this scouse-scot YouTube channel, you will learn how Peirce's pragmatic semiotic theory of semiosis can help to enhance and improve your visual communication. I have many more Peircean semiotic topics to discuss, but I would be interested in hearing about your semiotic ideas. Add a comment below. And if you like this video, check out my other semiotic videos and consider liking and sharing those videos with others. You see, the more we creatives discuss semiotic theory, the easier its application into our creative processes will be. Over the years, I have collaborated with other design academic researchers and Peircean semioticians to develop a designer-centric explanation of Peirce's theoretical language. If you are interested in reading my Semiotic Rosetta Stone academic writing, then you can visit my academia.edu link in the description. As a fellow creative and a published design author, I also have links in the description to my scouse-scot Redbubble shop featuring illustrated and typographical GIF ranges, and to my 2014 design book published by Bloomsbury Publishing, Interface Design, an Introduction to Visual Communication in UI Design. Any other books on Peircean semiotics I've mentioned in the videos are also listed in the description. Check them out too. Thanks for watching. Check out the other videos, like and share them with your friends, and hit the bell button to be notified when next week's video is published. See you all again next week for more Semiosis 101 to help illustrators and designers to enhance your visual communication skills.